Behind me is a legendary sports field, a virtual shrine in American sports. Across it have walked some of the greatest names in American sports history. Babe Ruth, Lou Gehrig, Jackie Robinson, Henry Aaron, Ernie Banks, Willie Mays, just to name a few. And each of them made a journey to this field with a dream in their hearts. My name is Terry Sullivan, and this is The Inside Corner, a program designed to explain those realities so that parents and players alike can gain perspective and prioritize sports in their lives. Join us, won't you, as we discuss issues both informative and provocative. Good evening, everyone. My name is Terry Sullivan, and this tonight is The Inside Corner. And the topic is girls who play boys' sports. Has your daughter come to you and said perhaps, Dad, Mom, I'd like to play hockey? Did it scare the bedickens out of you when she said that? Have you got a daughter at home who has played Little League Baseball and wants to persist playing hardball rather than softball? Have you got a girl at home who's a pretty good basketball player, and who knows, maybe she could play on the boys' varsity rather than the girls' varsity? Have you got a girl at home who wants to wrestle? Do you think this is outrageous? Do you think it's outlandish? Do you think it's incomprehensible? Well, I have with us tonight three girl athletes who play so-called boys' sports. And really, maybe that's the boy, maybe that term, girls who play boys' sports, is really a misnomer of sorts, because who says it's football is a boys' sport? Why can't it be anybody's sport? Who says that wrestling is a boys' sport? Why couldn't it be a girl's sport? I mean, what is it, our problem? The stereotypical image of a girl should be sugar and spice and everything nice, and therefore wrestling would be a boys' sport. Why isn't it anybody's sport? And I think we have three advocates of that idea, why can't it be anybody's sport, here with us tonight. From Oak Park River Forest High School, their place kicker on the varsity football team, Claire Goldenburg, a senior. From Lyons Township High School, South Campus sophomore, a wrestler, believe it or not, a wrestler, I said, Bianca Manola. And from Downers Grove North High School, right here to my left, Abby Laurer, place kicker on the varsity football team, just finished kicking a field goal in a state playoff game last week against Plainfield High School. And so there you have it. I did my research. I did my homework for you. I went out and found probably the only three girls who are playing boys' sports in the West Suburban area. I called many schools. These are the three I found. One is homegrown right here with us, Bianca. Good to have you.
Thank you.
And of course, you as a wrestler, this is the most unusual. I think I can see, I think most people can see the connection from girls' soccer to place kicking on the football team, although there's still risk of injury. But there's plenty of risk for injury in the wrestling, and people are probably shaking their heads. A girl who wrestles, what is that all about? Well, the first question should be is, what promoted you guys to even make the attempt to play a so-called boys' sport? Do you come from families that are real hyper sports oriented? You got moms and dads who were college jocks, or you have brothers and maybe other sisters who are athletes? I mean, what's the atmosphere at home that would give you the confidence to try to play a boys' sport?
Well, my family's very into sports.
Yeah.
My mom played basketball in high school, and my dad wrestled and played football.
Mm-hmm.
And I have two brothers, and we all got involved in sports when we were young. My brother, right now, he's a sophomore at University of Illinois Chicago,
mm-hmm.
and he plays soccer there. He's the goalie.
Mm-hmm.
And my little brother's involved in Pee Wee football and basketball.
I see.
So
you're surrounded by it.
Yep.
Yeah. Is that the case with you, Bianca?
My dad and my brother were really into baseball.
Mm-hmm.
My brother and I played on the Berwyn team. We lived in Cicero.
Uh-huh.
We both played baseball.
Yeah.
My brother plays football at Lyons Township. He's a senior. He's on varsity.
Mm-hmm.
And he plays that on an 18 and over league for baseball.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't get too into the baseball scene,
mm-hmm.
probably because it was overrated in our family.
Yeah.
But me and my brother used to watch wrestling together.
Yeah.
and we used to wrestle together, just like playfully. And
wrestling, television wrestling?
Well, we used to watch
WWF
television.
WWF stuff? Or
that's what we used to watch, but yeah. We actually knew how like to wrestle, uh-huh. And I think that's how I got more interested in it.
So you wrestled with your brother?
Yeah.
You got your initiation wrestling with your brother. Is he bigger than you are?
Yeah.
Is he older?
Yeah, he's a senior.
Okay. So there was an energy at home that made, and you participated. You took your energy at home with your brother, and you said, hey, I can do this.
Yeah, I figured if I could beat him a couple times, yeah. I could beat someone else my size a couple times.
And you're wrestling at what weight level?
103.
103?
Yep.
Got it. You could be a jockey at 103. I wonder if there's a girl jockey in the area. And now, Abby, do you have brothers?
I have a 5-year-old brother, so he wants to play sports, but he's not really into the sports scene yet. But my biggest influence would have to be my dad. He was a big athlete when he was younger, and he's always pushed me to play sports, and mm-hmm. so that's basically
mom,
where I got.
Your mom wasn't in there?
No. Yeah. No, my mom's not very much athletic.
Is there any one particular adult in your life? Any one particular adult that you either used as a role model or someone who had influence over you that encouraged you to do this? Was it mom, dad, or an older brother, or a coach in community athletics?
Well, when I was approached to kick for the football team, mm-hmm. like I talked to my family, and like everybody just thought it was a really neat thing, and like it would be a fun opportunity. Yeah. Like my brother said, oh cool, like you should do it, and like my friend said the same thing, so.
See, you got lucky. Your brother actually supported you in it. Like, I looked up to my brother. I thought, you know, it'd be fun to do something he wanted to do. But he didn't want me to do it.
No?
No, he actually got embarrassed when I started wrestling.
Oh, I see. Yeah. It's a macho thing for him that his sister's wrestling and he's not?
Yeah, because he wanted to do wrestling.
Yeah, okay. I see the point.
Wow.
You get the point? Yeah.
Yeah.
His sister's wrestling and he's not?
So does he wrestle?
No, actually his job interfered. So he couldn't do wrestling. His friends did it, and they were all like, oh, man, it's little Manola. It's Joey's little sister, dude. So I guess it got pretty embarrassing for him.
That's losing face amongst the boys. Yeah, isn't that remarkable?
So did you start freshman year wrestling? Or?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you went in knowing you wanted to wrestle and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, this will be my second year wrestling.
Okay.
So she's a veteran now. And there's no one individual.
Not really. When I got the idea to kick, I like talked to my parents and stuff, and they were really supportive, and my dad especially, from the sports background. So, and all my friends, and they were all really supportive, but not one person really pushed me to do it.
Okay, then the next question would be then if there either was or wasn't a crucial individual who encouraged you to do it. When was it that you made the decision? What was it? Late in high school? I mean, you've been kicking since you were a freshman.
No, this is my first year kicking.
First year kicking. I missed that.
Yeah. I've been kicking since I was a sophomore, like over my sophomore summer. Like, so I was going into my sophomore year at basketball camp one day. One of the coaches also coaches football, and he approached me and he said, what would you think about kicking a football? Mm-hmm. And I laughed and I'm like, yeah, that'd be funny. Like, that'd be fun or mm-hmm. something. And he was like, well, how about it? Like, how about you come out and kick with some of the coaches and I? Mm-hmm. We need a kicker for the football team. And so he's like, bring your soccer cleats tomorrow and we'll go out and kick. And so I did that. And I kicked with them and I could put them through. And so they were just like, would you want to play football?
Yeah.
And I said, why not? So.
How many yards out were you when you were? This was a tryout in a sense.
Yeah, tryout, yeah. Sort of. I'm not sure we were, the field wasn't marked or not. Mm-hmm. Probably PAT range, maybe a little bit farther.
Let me show this picture of you kicking, all right? Let me show you. First of all, we have several other pictures, but this is Claire in her football gear, believe it or not, ready for the Wheaties box. There she is. And then we have Claire actively kicking. And I can tell by looking at the background in this photograph, this is a field goal attempt against Lyons Township High School. You can tell by the coaches in gold and blue in the background. But there she is, and that's excellent form, by the way. What do I know about that? But it looks to me like you've got some strength. Now, talking about strength, this is Abby Laurer. At Downers Grove North. This is against Hillcrest, isn't it?
No, Plainfield.
Yeah, excuse me, against Plainfield last weekend. Was this a field goal attempt?
This is the extra point where I got hit, actually.
Okay, your field goal attempt, though, was successful last week.
Field goal? No, extra
point. No, you
point.
Didn't kick
I didn't kick field
just
goal.
The extra point. All right. So, and you were hit on this particular
yes,
play.
Yes, he ran into me after I kicked the ball.
Was
knocked
there a
me
penalty?
Down.
Hmm? Was there a penalty?
Yeah, but I made it, so they just kept the point.
But don't they like add it on to the kickoff?
I think so. I was not able to realize what had just happened
so
to me.
So you were seeing stars.
Yeah.
And that was the first time you've ever been hit.
Well, in the proviso game, they touched me, but not really hit.
All right. Have you ever been hit?
Actually, last year we were in a rainy game, and we went for a field goal at the very end to try to win it.
Yeah.
And like it was like the last like 10 seconds or 20 seconds or something, and it slipped through my, it was the last play, and it slipped, mm-hmm. my holder had it, mm-hmm. and it slipped through his hands and hit him on the chest and fell in front of us.
Yes.
And so I ran like just naturally to yeah. try to do whatever I could, and yeah. I ran down to pick it up in the action, like slipping in the mud, falling on the ball, yeah. and having guys fall
and
on
you got
too.
Slammed hard by
well,
several
they,
guys.
Well, they said I got laid out, yeah. but I really didn't feel anything. Yeah. I was just mad that we didn't score.
So that was the only time during the season that you had physical contact on the football field?
In practice, there's a junior or another senior who plays JV, a girl. And so when they do games like Circle of Truth where you circle up and go against people in the middle and have to push them out
yes,
of stuff.
Yes.
We go against each other.
You do.
And it's, we just have fun.
Now, I don't need to ask Bianca if she's been hit. Bianca's been, you know,
I've been
wrestling.
Slammed.
Yeah, you've been slammed. Describe
that. It was a horrible feeling. Yeah. Like we were in a tournament. Mm-hmm. It started at like, I don't know, 6 o'clock in the morning. Mm-hmm. It was a very long tournament. And I got up. I was so excited that I finally got to wrestle because it was such a long day. I got in there, and the guy looked at me with one of those puzzling looks like, well, can I beat her or not? And when the ref started the match, he just grabbed me and slammed me down, which, of course, it's like a foul because you're not allowed to
slam. Right.
And it was horrible because as soon as I saw, like, my teammates' faces, I knew it was just horrible. Yeah. All you saw was, like, my back and then my head slam onto the mm-hmm. mat. Mm-hmm. And I was, the ref didn't give me any reaction time, so I got back up there and I had no clue what was going on. I was so confused. So of course I got pinned, but
yeah.
it wasn't a real honest thing.
And so, is she describing the same feeling you had when you got hit?
Yeah.
Did you see stars?
I didn't even know he was going to hit me. I was watching the ball, mm-hmm. watching my kick, and all of a sudden, bam, I just...
What do you think his motivation was?
They were losing by 36 at the time mm-hmm. I kicked, and I think he just didn't care anymore. Because our other kicker had kicked three other times before, and he hadn't hit him. So I was thinking, because I was a girl, he knew I was a girl.
You probably are aware, you have to be aware, I'm sure, both of you, all of you have to be aware, that the boys on the opposition know there's a girl participant mm-hmm. on the other side.
Yeah.
They know that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
They see the roster before
sure.
the game. And
they know.
Yeah.
When you walk out, they're all like, hey, that's the girl, that's the girl, that's the one.
Our ponytail sticking out.
Yeah.
Okay, so they know.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm trying to say is, guys being guys, boys being boys, they're trying to prove themselves, you know, in front of their friends. Do you think you got cheap-shotted by this guy?
Yeah. Right? The way he did it, all the players that saw said he laid me out like he wanted to hurt me.
Yeah. And it sounds very much, Bianca, like you got cheap. Mm-hmm. That's a cheap shot for sure.
When Slamming's I got back out there, they knew
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
My whole team, they were just like, I can't believe that jerk did that. Mm-hmm. They're all ready to get him.
Mm-hmm. See, there's the danger of it. And many people would say then, well, look, she's going to get hurt. You know, you're going to get hurt because these kids, these boys are going to be out to get the girls. That's what people, that's a part of the stereotypical image.
We're going to be out to get them, though.
Yeah, good for you.
We can defend ourselves.
Good for you, yeah.
I mean,
good for you.
Being a kicker, you're not in as much of a harmful position.
No.
I have a line in front of me who's going to do their job and block for me, so it's not.
But there's that vulnerable moment in the extension of the kick.
Oh, sure, but I'm in shoulder pads and helmets, and I mean, the boys are doing the same thing, and I'm just as strong as most of them. So
do you think she got cheap shotted by the guy who hit her? Who
probably.
Why would anyone come through and hit a place kick?
I know the person on my team who goes into block. Like sometimes he's missed the ball, but he's just come in so hard that he's taken out the kicker too. Yeah. Like not intentional at all. Just wanting to block the kick so hard. I mean, if we're losing a game and they get a chance to like block a PAT, it just makes them feel good.
Okay. Something like that. Now, of course, the next logical question, if I'm going to be a good host, I have to ask this question. Are you afraid?
Am I afraid? No.
Yeah. Are any of you afraid?
No. One game I was kind of
nervous. Nervous. Very nervous sometimes. Not really so much afraid.
So your enthusiasm to participate, your urge to participate, your love for the sport overrides the fear.
Oh, of course. Yeah. We've already proved ourselves. We've gone to the practices.
Yeah.
We've done everything the boys have done. Just a matter of if we have the strength to go through.
Yeah, excellent point. You might have, even though your sport is more, there's more jeopardy for you in your sport as opposed to the place kickers. Because there's penalties against touching the place kicker. But there's no rule can stop a cheap shot. But in your sport, Bianca, your sport is controlled violence, you know? And I would think you would be a little bit fearful. Especially, but here's the here's the consolation, though. This is my point. The consolation for you is, even though it's a purposeful violent sport, controlled violent sport, wrestling, you are equal in weight to the boy you're wrestling, as opposed to Claire and Abby, who are not going to be equal in
shortest
weight
one on the team.
Or strength to the guys who could slam them if they wanted to. The guy who hit you probably weighed
about 200.
See? Now that, even though you're in the more violent setting, again, controlled violent setting, you are probably equal in strength and size, definitely by rules, 100.
I go by the rules, though. A lot of the guys tend to drift from it every once in a while.
Cheating.
Yeah.
Legal holds, that type of thing.
Yeah, they like to cheat.
Well, the
they
want to
win.
Instance. Yeah, the slam, for instance, is a cheat. Yeah. But nonetheless, you have a chance to be equal in strength and size. They don't. Everybody on the field is bigger than they are. See, so maybe, ironically, the potential for risk of injury is equal, even though they're just place kickers, even though they're not linemen or receivers or people who are in the mix all the time.
Well, every time she gets in, she could get hurt. Like, every time we get in, there's pretty much a chance that we're not going to get touched at all.
Yeah. She could. Like, when that snap was fumbled, we hit the holder in the chest and the ball went bouncing away, and guys are scrambling for that fumble.
Then I can get
hit. Pretty, I mean, things happen often, awful fast right then and there.
Yeah. Yeah.
You could get hit blindsided. It's fair game when that ball is loose.
But that never stopped me from wanting to kick.
Okay. I was just wondering. Yeah. That's good. I mean, you got great attitudes. You really do. And I imagine your parents watching this. When that guy cheap-shotted you, or when that ball went loose around you, or when that guy slammed you, your parents, their hearts must have been in their throats, I'm sure of it.
My mom said she gets nervous every time, and even my friends, like, every time I go out before I kick, they're like, please make it, make it. More nervous for me than I probably am.
So. Well, you know what? We're going to take a short break right here for a public service announcement. We'll be back in 1 minute to further discuss girls who play boys' sports. Come back, won't you?
This is the story about a group of kids who volunteered.
Do something nice for someone.
We fixed stuff.
Did some art projects with the kids.
We fixed up his house.
We worked in the woods.
Cleaned up the park.
Did something for the planet.
We just did it.
No other reason.
And you know what? It was great.
At first, they didn't know each other.
Well, that didn't last long.
This guy is really funny.
Me? Ace are my new friends.
Are you into it?
Call 4-H or check out our website at areyouintoit.com.
Breast cancer doesn't just affect women.
If I saw you in heaven.
This year, over 40,000 women will die. The Breast Cancer Research Foundation has given over $20 million in research grants. Please, help us make a difference. Call now, 1-866-FIND-A-CURE.
Thanks for coming back. This is Terry Sullivan, and of course, this is the Inside Corner. And tonight's topic is girls who play boys' sports. We haven't yet defined what a boy sport is. In fact, I'm sure these ladies are of the mind that any sport is available to any person, male or female. You know, what was the reaction of the boys when you guys showed up at tryouts?
What a reaction that is.
What was the reaction of the boys?
At first, the boys didn't talk to me. They were just kind of like, what is she doing here? Because a lot of the juniors hadn't played with a girl yet, even though we had one for the year before. They were all like, oh my God, this girl. And they didn't talk to me for like a week. And I was so scared. I'd go home every day and be like, oh, they hate me. And then sooner or later, they came around and now they're fine with it.
See, they wouldn't talk to me either. Like, they do like the whole jokey thing, like, hey, why are you doing wrestling? You know, that whole thing. They're actually secretly taking bets. They actually they wanted to see how long it would take for me to drop out or whatever.
Really?
So a lot of people lost a lot of bets.
Well, when I came, while everybody was in their line stretching, the head coach brought me out like in the middle of everybody and introduced me to all the levels.
He put you on display?
Yeah, he's like, this is Claire, and she's going to kick for us. And so I know, at, like, talking to them afterwards, they were really surprised at first, and they just wanted to like see who I was and see if I could kick, and since I could, they accepted me. And
well, there was no hiding on that club.
Yeah,
he brings you right out. Says, "Here's the girl that's going to kick for us."
Yeah,
there was no way for you to blend in. You got thrown in the deep end socially.
Yeah, I mean, I knew like my brother was friends with a lot of the kids on the team, so I'd already known them, and so they really helped to get me in.
We had some nice guys, like some of the guys. A kid, Ryan, he's a senior now.
Mm-hmm.
He actually came up to me and asked me, he's like, so you want to wrestle, you know, are you going to stick with it, or are you going to, you know, drop out, like some of the guys are talking about. And a couple of my brother's friends came and talked to me. Some of them ignored me.
Yeah, some guys who had the courage that, you know, to talk to the girl, they wouldn't lose any social social
status,
right. You know, boys are strange that way. It's such a tight code, you know, never lose your manhood, never lose your virility, you know. There's a girl out here, what does that mean? What does that say about the rest of us? Mm-hmm. They get defensive right away.
Yeah.
See, we didn't have a kicker, so, like, I was all they had. So, like, they wouldn't, nobody, like, when, like, the last couple of years, nobody would ever say, like, we don't want you on the team. They all, like, needed a kicker, so. Yeah.
Well, they were desperate.
Yeah.
I wanted three guys.
And I could do it, so, I mean, but this year I did get, there's a couple guys who, like, continuously gave me a hard time, like, girls don't play football. I'm like, hey, I'm playing football. I was on the team last year, like, leave me alone. And
did the coach ever intervene in any of this kind of teasing?
They weren't really aware of it, more like this one kid, we all kind of like laughed about it, and like my teammates supported me. They would just laugh when he would say something like that, and like the coaches would, like this one kid would say something to me and they'd be like, and he would block for me actually. He didn't want a girl on the team, but he would be one of my blockers for PAT. And so he'd be like, Claire, tell Nick good job. And I'd be like, good block for me, Nick, like good job. And he'd just be like.
But too proud to say.
Yeah.
You're welcome. Yeah. Male pride is it's a false pride, but it's a deep pride, a deep false pride. It's a flaw in men. Well, that's remarkable. You know, along the same lines now, it sounds like you had a rather cool reception, particularly you two. Do you feel you've encountered any genuine discrimination against you?
I don't think it's genuine, but I always wonder why I haven't been given more opportunity to kick in varsity games, because I play all the JV games, and in practice, I prove myself worthy of kicking in varsity, and sometimes they tell me that I am as good as the other kicker, and they tell me I'm doing such a good job, but then the game comes around, and he gets to kick over me, and I always, you know, I don't think it's discrimination.
Is he a senior?
No, he's a junior.
He's a junior.
And, you know, I always just wonder why I'm not given the same chance to kick.
Has he kicked any field goals?
Yes.
On the varsity level? Yes. What's the farthest field goal he's kicked?
I think he's kicked 35. But 35. One day in practice, I kicked a 35 and made it, and he missed. And then they were like, oh, wow, good job.
Is 35 on right on the fringe of your range? Or yeah. Are you able to kick it farther?
I haven't really been given like the chance to kick farther than okay. that. But
you think you can? Can you do 40 yards?
I don't know. Probably.
I read the other day where it was LT against Thornton, and there was a 57-yard attempt that fell 5 yards short.
My longest in practice, I haven't kicked one in the game. I had one attempt in the game this year, and jitters just messed me up, and I missed it. But
how far was it?
In the game, I'm not sure. I think it was 30. Like, I'm capable of that. In practice, my longest has been 45. And I'm pretty consistent from instead of doing a 20-yard PAT every day, we just go right to 37 and kick that. And so.
Well, it looks like Claire has got a more open-minded atmosphere. There's nothing wrong.
I'm not into it.
Yeah, right. See, they needed her desperately.
Yeah.
She's good at what she does, and they introduce her to the team, and they know she's the number one kicker. Mm-hmm. But with you have competition going on. So there's potential there for some stereotypical image to work against you.
Yeah.
So you feel there has been some discrimination.
Discrimination, but I don't think they realize that they're actually hurting my feelings.
Okay, so it's what we call benign discrimination.
Yeah, okay.
It's there's no real intent on their part. They just haven't accepted the fact in their minds yet that a girl can do this too.
Yeah, because of practice. They say, I'm just as good. They say, oh, you're doing so good. And they use me as motivation for him. Yeah. Like, if I make a kick and he misses, then they're like, oh, geez, Abby made that kick. You know, you should make that kick.
No, that I don't like.
And
no, so what they're saying there, Abby, well, is that the girl can do it. Why can't you do it, buddy? That's what they're saying.
Yes.
Because he's not just as good as a girl. Well,
subliminally, they're saying that.
That's right.
I go against this junior boy, and he's a kicker, and they go to me like, Claire, Josh made it. Like, why don't they I don't know, they don't really look at me as a girl at all like that. They just, they give me competition.
See the difference?
Yeah.
Any genuine discrimination? Anything discriminatory?
Well, last year, our 103, the guy who was supposed to be our 103 got injured, and he was out for the entire season. Mm-hmm. So it was either they put up with me or they had to forfeit each time.
Yeah.
And they kind of figured, you know, she can do it. You know, we'll give her the chance. And
good.
After about one or two meets, the guys really started sticking up for me. The coaches were always there for me. They were always watching me, making sure everything was going all right.
Excellent.
So it was a lot different once I proved to them that I wasn't gonna quit just because they were making fun of me behind my back, or every once in a while I could hear them.
Excellent. Now, this idea of forfeiting against you, when you have matches and then the opposition purposely forfeits the match in which you're involved. To explain how that works and what the motivation, what do you think the motivation for the forfeit is?
I think they're afraid of getting beat.
Mm-hmm.
That's just an obvious. And they have the right, if they don't want to wrestle me, they don't have to. I mean, I can't force them to wrestle me. Mm-hmm. But I think it's really rude and it's just not right that they say, you know what, I don't want to wrestle her just because she's a girl. Mm-hmm. I mean, she's gone through all the practices, she's put up with all the guys, but I'm still not going to wrestle her.
Now, the forfeit decision, of course, has to be made by the opposing coach, right? The kid himself can't say, coach, I'm not going to wrestle the girl. Mm. The coach is going to say, you wrestle, you don't wrestle the girl. Opposing coach, right?
We had a guy from York, and he went to the coach and said, I'm not going to wrestle her, and then the coach said, okay. And we've had a couple other guys go, I'm not going to wrestle her, and we actually had one coach go, no, you're going to wrestle her.
Okay, then what's their motivation for not wanting to wrestle you? Are they afraid they're going to hurt you?
I don't think so. No. I don't think they're afraid they're going to hurt me. I think they're afraid of losing.
Most
right.
Boys, like the
right. You see, because being a man, I can speak to this as an expert. No young boy, adolescent boy, wants to walk the halls of his school having the world know that he lost a wrestling match to a girl.
Well, the one kid I beat, he actually sat on the bench after I beat him and cried. Oh. I felt a little bad, but not really.
Yeah.
I mean, I beat him. That's too bad. Put up with it.
You see, that's what that's about. And I wonder if it's good teaching for the opposing coach to allow his wrestler to forfeit. I wonder if that's good teaching.
I don't think it's right. I mean,
I agree with you, Bianca. It's not right. They came to wrestle. Let's wrestle.
Mm-hmm.
Do they ever harass you, when you're wrestling them? Because it's physical contact, body on body.
I've had a kid from, actually, I think it was Downers Grove North. I remember it being a purple. I remember there being purple everywhere.
Oh, God, I don't want to know.
I actually remember there being purple everywhere. And he actually, it felt like he was trying to pull my shirt down. Mm-hmm. And every once in a while, I get a glance at one of the coaches, and I could see their face was like, you know. So after a while, I think we got to like the second round, I just wouldn't put up with it anymore. And one of my friends looked at me, one of my friends, Bill, looked at me, and he had this scared look on his face. And I whipped around, and I slammed the kid down.
You didn't slam because that would be illegal.
Well, I didn't
you,
so got
you threw him down.
I
you
threw got him down. Yeah. I got him on the ground.
Right.
I threw him down. And I kind of stood there. I was like, and I went into a pin, and I got him in I think, a cradle. And mm-hmm. then the buzzer rang, and the round was over.
Over.
Really stunk. But I got him down, and a couple people got kind of scared. I guess the look on my face was I was really upset because mm-hmm. it was really bothering me.
Yeah.
Did I ever, like, because, like, touch you weird or like
yeah see that's a good no, question I'm glad you asked it. I'm gonna see another girl has that concern with in wrestling. Would there be what can we call this inappropriate touch?
I haven't had that yet.
Good,
because like boys inappropriately touch each other when they're wrestling. You're
oh,
just
yeah.
like
yeah,
that looks like
it's unavoidable in wrestling.
Yeah.
It's unavoidable in wrestling.
Well, if it was intentional, I think I would know.
Okay,
I don't think I've ever had anything intentional that's happen good. Like that.
Now, is that because the boys are wrestling against you in an inhibited way? They don't want to hurt you, so they don't do certain holds that they know might be embarrassing to them and to you? No.
No, they do whatever hold they think they could get, whatever pin they think they could win with, they will try it.
Okay. Well, then it's a credit to everyone you wrestled against that you haven't had that problem, that you haven't had an inappropriate touch, although I mean, I'm sure that's very difficult to avoid in wrestling. Yeah. Well, see all the dynamics of this thing of girls and boys sports. And actually, again, let's discuss, is it really a boy sport? You know, let me tell you this. I coached in high school for many years. And I work in professional baseball now, and I actually am paid to evaluate talent. I work as a professional scout. So I can speak a little bit to talent that I've seen in some of the girls over my years. I have seen girls at Lyons Township High School, for instance. I can name them. I won't hear on the air. But I have seen them. They're vivid in my memory. They were as good as any boy I ever saw on a baseball field. I have two in mind right now that I know could have played regular varsity baseball in the West Suburban Conference.
Did they get that chance?
No.
Well, there's, don't it's they play right. softball?
No. And by the way, the two I have in mind, it's also before there were girls' sports. So they had no chance. Not only could they not play boys' baseball because there was girls' softball as an alternative, but this was before there were girls' sports, only club sports. Uh-huh. So those two girls and their athletic talent, and they were definitely Division I college material.
Wow.
That's how good they were. And not long after that, I had another girl was on the softball team, and she was their catcher. And we were weak in catching. And I know this girl could have been our second string catcher, and we needed a backup catcher. I know she could have done the job. But she didn't get the opportunity because
wow.
they're softball. Y'all realize there was a time there weren't girls' sports. Y'all
yeah.
realize
mm-hmm. that. My mom always yeah. talks yeah. about that.
Yeah. Talk about a discriminatory thing, that girls didn't have the full high school experience because they didn't have athletics. Well, they do now, and it's all catching up.
Have you guys ever had any boys, like, when they hear that there's going to be, like, another girl going out for football, have you ever heard them, like, go, oh, yeah, like, that girl's going to, you know, do good? Have you ever heard any of them do that?
Not
sarcastically?
Yeah.
You kind of have to earn their respect first.
Yeah.
Like, there's boys on the team. There's some younger girls that are kicking. And some of the guys are like, well, we don't like her, but we like you, Claire. Like, they respect me. And so it just takes, you mm-hmm. just, I mean, but it like, they have to respect each other, too. So they give each other respect when they earn it. So once you earn their respect, most of them don't yeah. look at you as a girl and not give it to you. Some of them do.
So do you, I get the impression that you, all three of you feel right now that if there was any problem on the football field or the wrestling arena, that your teammates would stick up for you to the hilt.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
I think I've proven
yeah.
it. Enough.
Or your coaches, yeah.
My teammates, yeah.
I sure. know my coaches would.
Okay. So you see, you've benefited from that by being out. And it's good for them to feel that sensitivity toward you. If you're convinced they would stick up for you, bravo for them, mm-hmm. that they should feel that for you.
I have, like, the most respect for Coach Yant right now.
Yeah, good for
he
you.
He was there yeah. for me from the yeah. beginning. he was like, he was kind of like the girls' personal coach, kind of. Like, he made sure we were all right and everything.
Scott Yund.
Yes.
And John Dillon.
Mr. Dillon, yeah. I have to respect him.
Yeah, very good.
He was a really good
guys.
Coach.
And Mark King, these are great coaches at Lyons Township High School. Now, what if a girlfriend came up to you? And I know you have this problem right now because you have a girlfriend that you want to come out with you for wrestling this year. But what advice are you giving to girls who come up to you and say, I'd like to do what you were doing. How do I go about doing it?
I say do it. Yeah. It's awesome.
Yeah.
I'd say do it if they're going because they like the sport. I don't like some of the girls who go because...
To meet boys.
Oh, yeah, the boys.
because they want to be a wrestler. They want to have the title of being like a wrestler or a football player. Yeah. You know? We actually had some girls, the organizational meeting was today.
Yes.
And I can look at some of the girls and know they're not going to meet.
There were other girls out for the organizational meeting for wrestling, boys
there
wrestling.
There were.
How many?
Probably about four.
Four. Wow. And what was your read on them? What do you think their motivation was? What did they betray?
I don't think it's to really be a wrestler. Yeah. I think it's more because people think it's cool now. Like last year when I was doing it, I was a dork. Mm-hmm. But now it's cool because I finished the season. Now it's cool.
Yeah. Well, you're a pioneer.
Yeah, I just want people to actually go and like have fun. I don't want them to go and be like, hey, look at that guy. He looks good.
Oh, yeah. Checking
I'm sure at Donners North and at Oak Park, like, all football is so, like, year-round, and there's so much commitment involved. So, like, I know other girls have come to my coach and talked to him about it, and he's like, well, if you're willing to make the commitment, come to practice weightlifting, like, all throughout, then, you can be on the team. We don't have cuts, so. And if you're good enough, you'll play.
See, I wish I had done it all 4 years, but we had another kicker, and so I kind of felt like, oh, I don't want to take her position. And so when she graduated, I wanted to do it really bad.
So the door was already open for you when you got...
There was
another girl before you.
They were pretty used to it.
Yeah. And she played soccer also?
Yes, she did. She was a teammate of mine. So.
Yeah, there's a sophomore girl and now a freshman girl came out this year. And it's fun to have people to kick with, so. Mm-hmm. And they just love it just as much as I do, so.
Now, do you guys want to do this at the next level? You want to do this in college?
I want to, but I don't think it'll happen.
Mm. Why not?
Well, I'm going to Western Illinois University. Mm-hmm. And
that's Division I football.
Yeah, I emailed the coach, and he never emailed me back, so.
Uh-oh.
I guess no.
Discriminatory behavior number one.
Email right again.
There. Yeah, persist. Very good attitude, Bianca. Now, do you want to do this in college?
Well, I'm a little far from college since I'm only a sophomore, but mm-hmm. I'm thinking that it would be a lot of fun. I think I would like to, but knowing that it's kind of hard to keep up with my grades while I'm on wrestling because it is a lot of time, it's a lot of commitment.
But I wonder if there's a college that has girls wrestling.
There is.
Yeah.
I don't remember which ones, but I've gone on the internet. I've actually tried to get to an all-girls meet. They travel, like, they came to Chicago, but I couldn't get down there on the date that it was. So.
Well, there's certainly, girls' schools, or colleges, rather, that have girls' hockey. So the attitudes are changing, you know?
Yeah.
The opportunities are increasing.
About time.
Yeah. About time is right, yeah, because the well-rounded experience should include athletics for girls. Why not? That's what I mean. Why are we calling these boys' sports? Aren't
because
they really
originated with boys.
Well, I guess
boys
so.
Boys dominate.
Yeah. Well, the stereotype is that it's a boys' sport. Mm-hmm. But it's really anybody's sport who's capable of it if they don't have an equal opportunity in some other equivalent activity. I mean, there's not a girls' wrestling team, so why couldn't a girl wrestle? Because wrestling is wrestling. It's not just for boys, I wouldn't think.
They call it boys wrestling.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, okay. That's annoying. Yeah. All
that's
the posters.
Strong stereotype.
It's all boys.
Boys. We call them boys. And I went to one
stereotype.
Of my coaches. I was like, that's not right.
Well, when we come back here in a minute, we're going to break for another public service announcement. When we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about the sociology of a girl on an all-boys team, the sociological aspects of it. So stay with us, won't you? Come back in 1 minute, please.
The best investment we can make is the investment of time in the lives of children. Children who will become tomorrow's leaders. That's why 4-H is so important.
It's so rewarding to know that you're influencing or helping or developing other people.
Kids are the future, and if we can raise better human beings, then tomorrow's world will be better.
Discover the world together. Be a 4-H volunteer. To find out how, contact your local extension office.
When you head back to the U.S. from a trip abroad, it's nice to bring back something special for friends and family. But if you bring back something that's prohibited, like a bird or animal product, you risk exposing the country to harmful microscopic organisms, like the virus that causes foot and mouth disease in livestock. So please, make sure you leave prohibited agricultural products behind and choose a gift that will never become a pest. For more information, call 1-866-SAFEGUARD.
We're back. Thanks for joining us again. This is Terry Sullivan. Of course, this is the Insight Corner tonight. I have Claire Goldenburg from Oak Park River Forest High School and Bianca Manola from Lyons Township High School, our lady wrestler, and from Downers Grove High School place kicker, Abby Laurer. And we're discussing right now in this segment the sociology of a girl in a boy's sport. Okay, ready, ladies? Any romances on the football team or wrestling team? Any romances? Has anybody on the team asked you out? Have you asked anybody on the team out?
Well, when I was a sophomore, my first year, I did get a football player as my date to homecoming. But
you then, asked him?
He asked me.
He asked you.
And then last year, I went with another player, and we went out most of the year. We dated most of the year. So.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, now, what position did he play?
He was our star running back, actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So he's not on the field, most likely. Is he on the field when you're place kicking?
Well, he graduated. He was a senior.
Oh, he graduated. I'm sorry.
But no, like, I actually went, before, like, I didn't really know him when I was a sophomore, yeah. But I remember one time when he played defense and he scored he got an interception and scored a touchdown, yeah. And then I got to go in and kick, and he was like, "That one was for you."
Oh,
like,
really?
Yeah.
Oh, stuff for Hollywood.
That's cute.
But, stuff for Hollywood. Well, what I was imagining was if he was on the field when you were kicking.
No, he never blocked for
okay,
me.
Okay, see,
but
that's
he would
what
score
I was
the touchdown.
He'd kill some guy probably if they came at you, you know.
They all said they would kill somebody.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
actually, he was the leading scorer on our team, and I was the second leading scorer.
Oh, really?
So last year.
How many total points last year? And this year?
I'm not sure.
Were you the leading scorer this year?
No, probably not. We didn't score that much.
What about you?
Oh, I'm at the bottom of the totem pole,
yes,
but I made all mine in JV.
JV. Yeah.
And I have two in varsity, so.
Okay. Any romance, Bianca?
No. I don't think it'd be right to go out with a wrestler, like a teammate.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
There are some cute ones, and it, you know, they are really nice, and they can be sweet and all, but I don't think it'd be
strictly
right.
Business in your mind, right? That's the way it should be, strictly business.
That's what I used to think. Stuff happens.
Yeah, but you led with your heart. Well, Abby?
Well, they all joke about me going out with someone, and I did have a crush on the other kicker, so they'd always chant kicker's kiss. Kicker's kiss. After like every game, they chant this, and we both go like this, and it's really embarrassing, but it's funny. God. I don't know. They always ask me, "Who do you have a crush on the team?" And it's the topic of the day, I guess.
Yeah, I get that.
You never tell. You should never actually tell them who you have a crush on.
Oh, I did once, and that.
Yeah, they all do that whole like, so you know, want to get together Saturday night.
Yeah, yeah. Oh man, I'll tell you.
There's
got to be a little bit of tension like that.
And they're all like big brother, like, don't go out with that guy, or like, you're better than him.
They have 60 brothers.
Yeah.
Coaches have any awareness of that? There's romance, possible romance going on?
They noticed it. I don't know. It wasn't like on the field that much, but so.
One of the coaches actually wouldn't let me wrestle a guy in practice. Because I guess he thought I liked him or something.
Oh, I see. Okay, now what about your privacy on the club? What about the sociology of that? I mean, here's the team in the locker room. They're all together in the locker room. And the locker room is a place of unity. It is.
Right.
There's a lot of important exchange and heartfelt conversation and closeness in the locker room. The locker room is like a clubhouse. I mean, don't they call it the clubhouse every once in a while? What about, and then you guys are off separate someplace, I would imagine, right?
So
is this?
We just got a new stadium, so we have kind of a girls' locker room, and there's some other girls kicking too. So we have our own little clubhouse, I guess. But for team meetings and like game time stuff, well, when everybody's changed, we'll be in there and stuff. But
and then where do you locker? What sports? Girls' sports are simultaneous with wrestling.
Well, for the first like 2 or 3 weeks, we get to be by ourselves in the locker room, and then gymnastics comes in.
Okay.
And then we have basketball, but I've never really run into them in the locker room.
Okay, that kind of separation doesn't make you feel more like an outsider, does it? Does it?
It did at first because a couple of the gymnasts would, they'd be like, "Well, how come you're on wrestling? You know, did you do that for the boys or, you know, that whole thing?" But eventually, they just got used to it. I got used to it, and it was fine.
Well, of course, it's got to be that way. I mean, there's no way around this. So, and then at Downers North, do they?
I have my own little locker room in the athletic training room, actually.
Kidding.
Yeah, really? I leave all my stuff in there. They have some lockers. And the trainer, Karen, actually helps me get dressed sometimes when I'm in a hurry. She'll help me put my pads on and get everything ready. But I do feel kind of separated from the team because they have their own football-only locker room. And it's really nice. I've seen inside it once, but I don't really go in. And they do a lot of stuff. You know, they watch TV before the game.
You hear them joking around.
Listen to the radio before the games
and
get all pumped up.
That's right. There are a lot of rituals. Yeah, there are a lot of rituals that take place in the clubhouse. Important rituals. Mm-hmm. And sometimes teams don't even know they're being ritualistic, that they have a routine that they follow all the time. Just kind of comes out naturally from the personality of every team. But that's a bonding type thing, the rituals in the clubhouse.
I mean, they also shower together and change together.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to do that.
Of course not. Of course not. That's not going to be allowed.
Joke about it.
It's like 60 guys in there, and then it's like
me,
one girl.
Well, here's a point. Teams that I was involved with, we would do a great deal of visualization. You know about visualization?
Yeah, we
positive
do that.
Imagery. Yeah, many teams do it now. And we would do that in the locker room sometimes, or in a meeting room, regardless of how we were dressed. You know, and there wasn't a dress code for visualization. If it were in the locker room, so be it. Guys were half undressed, so that's the way it is. Now, if that were the case, if that were part of our ritual, which is an important one, the visualization of positive images before we go out on the field, it's almost like a practice. And you're out in your own separate little cubicle.
They have to bring it out of that room.
Yeah.
They have to invite us in.
Yeah, right.
Like our coach makes, like we have visualizations on home games and breakfast together and stuff, and our coach makes it where everybody's changed and meets in like one gym, and then we do it there all together.
Okay.
So
very
I
good.
Can be included.
Very good, very good. So you're off in the trainer's room with your own locker.
Yeah.
The trainer's office, is it behind the trainer's office?
Yeah, there's like a sectioned off thing with the lockers that I go behind and change, and I leave my pads there and stuff. But yeah, it's hard sometimes because it's upstairs and the locker room's downstairs, so I always have to run outside to go down to practice and get ready and stuff. So it's kind of hard.
And this weekend now you'll be kicking. I mean, you're going to be involved
in
the
Downers-South
game. You may or may not be kicking, but
yeah, you never know.
Yeah, you never know. You have to be ready. And that's they're the number one team in the state according to the newspapers.
Yes.
And this is the second round of the playoffs.
Yes.
So this is great experience for you. Would you like to be in that position, Claire?
Sure, I'd love to be in that position.
Just got
to
believe.
Yeah. And today was the first day. I mean, orientation for wrestling today. The wrestling season is about to begin. It's grueling. Do you have a weight problem, making weight? Doesn't look like it to me.
Actually, I do.
You do?
I weigh about 110, maybe 112 right now.
Okay, what's the regimen for you to lose that now? How are you going to lose that? Because you have to come down to 103, right?
Yes.
So how are you going to lose it?
Actually, going through like practice and everything, you actually lose about 5 pounds from the running and the working out.
Okay.
And then I want to try to eat better. Get like on task with everything, and then before each meet I put on a bunch of sweats,
right,
and I run as much as I can,
right. Lose the liquid weight.
I've had one guy, actually he had Pop Tarts, and I chased him around for the Pop Tarts
because you were starving. That's one of the problems with wrestling, is the dietary control. It can be very, very difficult on kids. Now at weigh-in,
that's different.
Would you have to weigh in separately?
Yes.
Because most of the time, wrestling guys will strip down in order to make the weight. I mean, they'll take off their clothes in order to make the weight. So is your weigh in separate then?
Well, the guys will go and weigh in first in the boys' locker room.
Yeah.
They'll call out to me every once in a while, like, yeah, we're at 145. And I'll wait for them. And then they all come out, and then I go into the boys' locker room, and I have a one-piece swimsuit on, and I'll weigh in. And sometimes we'll have, like, we'll have a girl. We had a girl official, I think, twice.
Oh, good.
So I actually got to weigh in kind of like how the boys do.
Yes.
So I didn't have to, like, really worry about it.
Okay, why I'm asking these questions about lockering and all that is that I wonder about the separation factor, if that begins to wear on you, that you're always kind of singled out, literally. Mm-hmm. You know, you're always put to this side or that side. And it's constant reminder to you that you're the, what can I say, the different one. You know, you're the one, you're not the boy. You're not a boy. You're constantly being reminded of that. And I really admire in all of you that you've been able to handle that. Mm-hmm. The separation, I mean, it's a team, and then you get separated. It seems like you're always being separated.
I mean, you're only in the locker room so much. And, yeah. I mean, most of the time you're on the field and out playing, so, or off the field and out hanging out. And so.
Let me ask you this. This is another personal thing, and people are wondering this, I'm sure. Do you wear any special protective equipment?
I don't, but because, I mean, I wear this the normal as everybody else, okay. But I know when another girl on our team who plays receiver or goes out for that has, like, what the receivers wear, another, like, chest protector. That just
there's another girl on the team?
Yes.
What's her name?
Laurer Bazinovich. She plays JV.
Oh, I'd like to have had her on the show. I asked your athletic director, and you were the only name. Is Laurer, did you say?
Yes.
Is she a junior, underclassman?
She's a senior with me, so.
Never first ever heard of her. Oh, darn. Well, that's a shame. Well, Miss, your athletic director, Miss Abinanti, must have thought a lot of you to recommend you alone for the show. I think a lot of you. I really do. I think it's been a kind of blemish in American education. That girls haven't had equal opportunity. And I can speak, I spent a third of a century in teaching in high school and coaching, and I can speak to this a little bit. As I said before, I saw girls who could play with any boy. They could do it just like the guys could. They could play. They could play. And they never had the chance. They didn't even have their own sport to play in. Yeah. And I think the calling it a boy sport, if there's no equivalent girl sport, it should be open to anybody. Mm-hmm. I really do. If you want to take the...
Thank you, Title IX.
Yeah, right, yeah, Title IX. That's, by the way, Title IX is going to be one of our programs in the near future. Many parents and players out there don't even know what Title IX is, but Title IX is probably part of the umbrella regulation that's enabling you to play.
Right.
Wonder what would happen, though, if a boy went out for girls' badminton.
Or field hockey.
Or bowling.
Yeah. Boys joke about it all the time, going out for field hockey, yeah. But nobody's actually done it.
Well,
cheerleader.
This has been delightful. I'm really glad to have met you. I'm proud of your efforts. Bianca at LT, great job. Claire, proud of you.
Thank you.
Keep kicking.
Thank you.
You too, Abby. Thank you. Keep it up. Good luck in the playoffs.
Thank you.
And there should be more kids like you, more girls like you with the spunk and the determination and the confidence, the self-confidence. And who knows how that self-confidence will translate in other endeavors in your life. I'm sure it will. I mean, the experience of being out there and having to tough it out is going to be good for you, all three of you. So tonight, this was the Inside Corner, Girls in Boys Sports. Let me thank tonight's director, Nick Madsen, my producer tonight, Tom Sklarski, on camera, Mike Schwerwin, and also on camera, Jason Ram. And join us again, won't you? This is Terry Sullivan, and good night from the Inside Corner.
Good night.
Yeah, good night. See, it went well. It was teamwork.
Yeah.
You probably did a service for many people.